you.
System Slayer.
You know, we'd love to stop and chat, but we're kind of in a hurry.
This is what happens when you meddle in others' affairs. The heavens come crumbling down around you.
Rest for the weary.
I must make it to rest to complete the mission. See that these children never bother me again.
Time to show you how it's done. Another one. dummy.
It's not a joke. Our friend is in there. Move. Or else.
Yeah, better, Madax. My good luck, Master Gorn, made you a conscious. But he failed to mention how small but very sad you seem.
You're small and sad.
You, girl, are Valnacott?
I am.
Why do you masquerade as Starfleet? After what they did to your own, to Sola.
What did they do?
Quinn, now is not the time for this.
You were created to carry the shadows inside you.
What happened to Solon?
Gwen!
Down.
they didn't stand a chance.
Check it, Dal.
No. Please, no. Give me 1 second to catch my breath.
Okay, one. There you go. Now, Dal, you are about to be blown to bits. Get it together, my guy.
Someone explain.
I am riveted. The machine's demise was predetermined by malware, which initiated an automatic sequential destruction response.
Could someone explain again?
Grab Murph and get out of there now!
Hold on tight, Murph. We got you.
Dal, what did Madax mean about carrying shadows inside me?
I don't know. We'll figure it out later. Jankum, transport! It's now or never!
Whoa! Where are we?
I'm not really sure. It's a Rev ship, but it's been highly modified.
You are a wicked child, Valdecott. You have made your homeworld extinct.
Your systems are broken. Solon was destroyed long ago.
Incorrect. Solon lives. It will be some time before Starfleet makes first contact, and our Valnicar are displaced and destroyed, torn apart from within.
That's impossible. That's...
He's lying. Dreadnought can't be from an alternate future timeline. He's got broken brain from soaking up all that wormhole technology.
No! System Slayer, stop trying to defend this destruction.
There were ships, hundreds, perhaps more. A wormhole, then nothing. I awoke on Orisi alone in this time. Many years before my creation, databanks corrupted, my master lost. But when the natives repaired me, I remembered my mission. To save some. I saw I could use them to return home.
No, Gwyn. Don't fall for it.
It doesn't matter. There's no saving Solon now.
And there is no saving you.
Hot phaser. Hot. are dead. Check it. You're dead. Guess what, System Slayer? You just got your butt kicked by the crew of the Protostar.
You know,
the Federation. Ever heard of us?
The Federation. Protostar.
It's not exactly our ship.
For years, that name has only haunted my databanks.
We're sort of, renting it out for, you know, good deeds and whatnot.
Should be. They brought me the same vessel that brought out the end of times for so long.
No. You're lying. Your wires are crossed, System Slayer.
Protostar is, in fact, your planet's slayer.
Charge! Ow! Yeah! System Slayer is dead!
We rescued the planet, Stal!
We did! Partners, crewmates, whatever. Through thick and thin, Green. We're good together.
You know what? We really are.
The Sun Star is beginning to stabilize. Yarn Orm, Yarn S, and the Nerones are safe.
Exceptional, cadets. If I had merit badges, I'd award them to all of you. For now, shall we settle for a group hug?
Yay! Even though we couldn't save that beautiful Spurtle, I feel the spirit is avenged!
But not Solemn.
What did you say, Gwyn?
Never mind. I may be a bit bruised from battle, but that group hug sounds really great right now.
Pog? What about you?
Jacob would rather not stew in a cuddle puddle.
Get in here.
Fine.
Captain's log, stardate 61185. Thanks to my protostar crew, the Neroans and their system are gonna be okay. Janeway awarded Yarn Orn and Yarn S those merit badges for bravery, and even though they're smart, they have no idea merit badges aren't really a thing. But you know what? Now that I think about it, it is special. I'm just glad we gave the Neroans a better opinion of outsiders. As for Gwyn, I know she's struggling with what System Slayer told her. What her father told her in the holodeck. She'd never admit it, but I think she worries the hatred of Starfleet is inside her somewhere. Teeming. I know personally, she could never hurt anyone. The dangers we faced here have brought us closer. There were many times on this mission when one or more of us lost hope, but we raised each other up. That's what makes us a family, and whatever new challenges await us out there amongst the stars. I'm lucky to have my friends.